it's time to play King's Stupid. I'm William Van Dyke, and welcome to King's Stupid, the only show on Radio 4 that started 20 seconds ago. It's the comedy panel game that's known in Spain as El King Stupid, known in Japan as Teenage Fighting Robot Shape Changer Atari Schoolgirl Panel Game, and known in Germany as Answer All Questions Immediately. So let's meet our guests. They're all in little tins, so I'll open them up. In the first one, the cute one from the Friday Night Armistice, Peter Bainham.
Hello.
So we can get to know a bit more about your tastes and aspirations, tell me, if you were an international baddie, where would you hide your secret base?
I think I'd have my secret base in Pontypridd in South Wales, because I think it would give a much-needed boost to the local economy. You know, like I could employ ex-miners to be my henchmen, and presumably there'd be some sort of news report on BBC Wales going like, Dim Thawr and a Pedwar and a Clywed and a massive missile pointed at America.
Right.
Yeah.
And if you had a tank full of deadly animals to drop people in, what animals would you have?
Poisonous cows, without a doubt.
Okay. Now, this tin contains actor and comic Simon Pegg.
Hello.
You've got a bit of tomato on you there, Simon. So, where would you hide your secret base and what's in the tank?
I'd have it in the Cotswolds. I disguise it as a massive cottage, about a mile high.
And what's in your tank, Simon?
I think I'd have to go for cats, William, because they can also be used as pets and they're nice. I like cats.
Deadly was obviously the word you didn't hear there. That's fine. Okay. Having a bit of trouble with this one, I'll have a go at it with a chisel. Ooh. Well, I think I got most of her out. From Late Lunch, Sue Perkins.
Hello.
Sue, where would you hide your base and what would you put in the tank?
I wouldn't have to hide my base, I just build it in Croydon. And the thing about people from Croydon is you can build anything wherever you like and they don't tend to take a lot of notice. In terms of animals, I would have two gerbils, a lady gerbil and a boy gerbil. And over a period of time, they would breed so that eventually the whole tank would be full of writhing gerbils. And so that eventually two baby ones maybe would crawl up a nose and you'd suffocate. And I've thought about that quite a lot.
Thank you. And in this tin, journalist and man, Dave Green.
Hello. Oh, hello.
I see you're a budget brand, Dave. If you were a baddie, where would you hide your base and what goes in the tank?
I think I'd hide my base in my lower intestine and visit it using the miniaturisation technology that, as an evil genius, I would have invented. And obviously then intruders would naturally be repelled by my body's defences, like phagocytes and white blood cells.
OK, well, that makes four guests, and that is as many guests as we could afford. There they are, ladies and gentlemen. OK, in the first round, I'd like you to make up rhyming couplets to remember important dates and facts. For example, in 1492, Columbus sailed the ocean blue. Or in 1997, there were 32 articles by Bernard Levin. Okay, you can confer, but bear in mind that you're competing against each other, so duh.
In 1999, the makers of Space 1999 are going to look pretty bloody stupid.
In 1492, a lot of other things happened as well, although we don't actually get to know about that, which just goes to show that history is a construct devised of disparate, supposedly significant events designed to bolster the rigidity of the current dominant system, that being capitalism. Doodly-doodly-doo. Thank you. Dave?
Oh, well, for every year, as long as I can remember, Christmas has been at the end of December.
In six, they'd never heard of Twix.
In 16, Jesus got his first BA honours in carpentry.
In 1994, Geoffrey Archer did not give money to a whore. That was that much was
ring,
proven.
Ring.
In 1996, I lost my virginity. Hooray.
Around about, and I can't be specific, so please don't write in, around about 1328, a horse managed, quite accidentally, I should point out, to fall on Catherine the Great.
So in 1989, I had sex for the second time. There's a rhyme.
In 1999, I'm going to have sex with a big equine. Just been promising
and
myself.
And back to Catherine the Great.
Any non-equine sex-related ones that we have?
No.
Well, in that round, I'm going to award Sue 1 point, Dave for a very useful one, 4 points, Nick can have 3, and Pete for his stamina, really, on the 1999 thing, can have 2 points. So, Dave, you won that round. For a bonus point, can you tell me your PIN number?
1492.
Okay, thanks very much. Okay, now it's time for our biographies round. I will describe myself as a character from history, and you have to determine my identity. Okay, you ready? Who am I? I was the ruler of France between 1799 and 1815. British soldiers knew... British soldiers knew me by the nickname Boney.
Napoleon.
I haven't finished. I gave my name to Napoleon Brandy, the Rue Napoleon. De Napoleon in Paris, I'm not listening, and the Napoleonic Wars.
My set of
laws for the French state was known as the Code Napoleon. I hail originally from Corsica, the home of Napoleon.
Paul Shane.
And shut up. And the psychiatric condition, shut up, known as the Napoleon Complex, is named in my honour.
Napoleon.
Now, if you think...
Napoleon.
It's Napoleon.
If you think Napoleon. You know the answer...
It's Napoleon's the answer.
Don't be afraid to take a guess now.
Napoleon.
You can buzz now. Dave got there first.
I think it was Napoleon Bonaparte.
Can I just check the card? Yes, it is Napoleon. 2 points to Dave. The next round is called William Van Dyke Plays Pop. I could now play you a jingle in which a big American voice says, William Van Dyke plays pop. But to be honest, I'd rather be torn apart by wolves. So I'm going to play some records, some well-known, some foolishly obscure, and there's a mystery in each song, which you're going to try and solve. Okay, listen carefully now to my 83rd favourite song of all time, I've Never Been to Me by Charlene. Okay, Charlene tells us she's seen things that a woman ain't supposed to see. Now, my question to Simon is, what are those things?
Godzilla.
I have to agree there.
This is rubbish, have you seen it?
She's too busy being undressed by kings to bother to go to the cinema and see Godzilla.
That's true.
Undressed by kings?
How many kings do you need to be undressed by?
About 30 kings all taking a different garment off.
So. Okay, any other things that women ain't supposed to see?
The bonnet of a car. Anything underneath the bonnet of a car. And the back of any electrical equipment.
The inside of my bedroom, apparently. I don't know whether there's a world... I mean, you can explain this to me if there's a worldwide conspiracy, but it does seem
to be
quite difficult to persuade.
Really. It's localised in the area wherever you may be at that time.
Right.
In a shocking tale of the unexpected style twist, how about the exact manner and time of her own death?
Well, that's why they won't go into my bedroom.
There's all kinds of things women aren't supposed to see. There's the extreme ends of the ultraviolet and infrared spectrum. An entire series of Red Dwarf.
No woman's ever seen that.
Star Trek.
So you think there's a very good reason, though, why she's never been to her?
Why is
because
that?
She's not a place, so she can't visit it.
Mm. Have you not been to me? It's just. It's
I've been to you, but I've not been to me.
Oh, okay.
Perhaps it's me, Arizona. Another imaginative place name from those wacky Americans.
You have a bone to me.
Welcome to me, Arizona.
Hi there, welcome to me.
Over there is us, and them's just over there.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.